Okay, so as discussed, now first we'll be seeing the sorting visualization of bubble sort. So what is bubble sort? Bubble sort is the simplest sorting algorithm that works by repeatedly swapping the adjacent elements if they are in the wrong order. So first we'll be seeing the visualization so that you get a clear idea of how it works. So in our program, we have taken 5 elements. So I'll just take 5. We generate it. Okay. So you can see the elements are 2, 92, 86, 11, and 84. And now out of this, 2 is the smallest element and 92 is the greatest element. So 2 should come first and 92 should come at the end. So let's sort it and see. Okay, we put the speed as 1 and now we'll sort it. As you can see 92 got shifted because it's the greatest element and 86 was the second greatest and then rest all accordingly got sorted. 2 is the smallest number, so it is sorted at the start of the array. Now let's see another one so you get a better idea, but this time we will be taking a larger number, that is, let's take 10 only. Let's generate it. Okay, so now here, which one is the smallest? 11 is the smallest number and 85 is the greatest number. Let's sort it and see. Can you see 60 is shifting and 85 is shifting because it's the largest? So the largest got already sorted at the end, then the second largest was 81. 58 got swapped with 61 because it is smaller, and even with 60. Now see, now I guess only one element is left. Yes, and now the sorting is done, where 11 is the smallest number and 85 is the largest number. So in this way, the sorting takes place. Now, in the next part, we will see the explanation for the bubble sort code we have written in 8086. Now we'll start the explanation for the code. First, we have taken dot model small. Dot model small has two segments. One is the data segment and the other one is the code segment. Now, data segment has the data and code segment has the executable part. Here we've taken 5 elements in the array, each of which is 16 bit. That is why we have taken define word. So it allocates 2 byte memory to each of the number. Now here we have taken length DW. What is this now? So this is the way of finding the length of the array in general. The dollar sign will give us the end address of the array and ARR will give us the starting address of the array. So now we have declared it. So for example, we take an example of this array itself. Suppose the dollar that is the end address is 1010 and ARR that is the starting address is 1000. So we will negate it. So 1010 minus 1000 will give us 10. And since they're 16 bit numbers, that is, it has 2 bytes, we divide it by 2. So 10 by 2 will give us 5. So we'll get 5 numbers. Now here we have just declared the strings for initial and sorted array. Now what is this new line DB1013? So 10 is called a line field and 13 is called a carriage return. So these characters are used to control the cursor position. The 10 shifts the cursor on the new line as the same column number and 13 returns the cursor to its initial position of the line. So every time you make use of these characters as part of your string or an array, it will shift the cursor to the new line and at the start of the line. Now in characters, we have used the minus and separator, and this will be the end of this data segment. Now we move on to code segment. So now in code segment, first, like, we have taken at the rate data, which is the starting address of DS, and it will be moved in AX and from AX to DS. And just to clear AX, we have moved 0000H in AX. Now to display initial array. Now using load effective address, we have moved the address of this array in DX. Now what are these three instructions? That is, int 21H checks in AH what service to call. Now since we have stored 9 in AH, it will call the print service, and the print service checks in DX what to print, but we have stored the address of the array. So what will it do? It will print from I, it will start from I and it will end till dollar. So it will print from here to here. And we'll see about this procedure later on. So here we initialize the outer loop. So since the outer loop should run n minus 1 times, we store the length in cx and we decrement cx by 1. Now again, for outer loop, the address is stored in SI through load effective address. And so cx is used for the outer loop counter and dx is used for the inner loop counter. So whatever value is in cx is moved in dx as well. Okay, now this part is the swapping part. So what it does is whatever element is at SI will be stored in AX and BX will store the element which is at SI plus 2. Now why plus 2? Because it is a 16-bit number. So we write SI plus 2. So this will be just consider at first number and second number. So we compare AX and BX. Now what is the basic of bubble sort? If you have a small like 5 numbers and the first number is smaller than the second number, then you don't have to do anything. But if the first number is bigger than the second number, then we have to swap. So this is what we are doing here exactly. That if it is proper, then we'll move on to this next. But if the first number is greater than the second number, then we will swap. So in swapping, the greater number is shifted to SI plus 2 and the smaller number is shifted to SI. Okay, in next, now we have just increment SI by 2 because it is a 16-bit number and we decrement the inner loop and we decrement the outer loop. Now this one is to display the sorted array. Again, over here, as we had discussed previously, the address of this is moved in DX through load effective address and INT21H checks in AH which service to call. So it has 9, so it will call the print service. And print service will find that this address is stored in DX. So it will again print from S from here till dollar. Okay, now we have interrupt to stop the program. Now we have written move AH,4CH and INT21H. So in MS-DOS, invoking that interrupt 21H while AH is equal to 4CH, it causes the current process to terminate. And it also uses the value of this register as the exit code of the process. Okay, so now we'll move on to the procedures that we use, like over here called underscore array. So we'll talk about that procedure. So first of all, this one is the first procedure till here, till end P. So what is this procedure? This procedure prints the elements of A, that is the array having the length elements, that is how many elements are there. So first we load the address in SI, we move the length of the array in the counter. Now in this loop it will print the value at ARSI in decimal. So this is again called, then this is the print separator. So separator will be moved in DL and this is used to print a single character, move AH, 02H. Now, we increment SI by 2 because again it's a 16-bit number. Now, in this loop, again LEA DX, new line. This is to print a new line and again you know from where to where it will print till dollar, till here, till dollar. Okay, so it will print till dollar. Now again return and this is the end of the procedure. Which procedure? This one, disp underscore ARR. Now, this is the last procedure in which from here, right till here. Okay. So in this procedure, what happens is it prints the value of it in decimal. Now we will see this in the, while we display the output, but I'll explain this procedure. First, we move SI in AX. Later on, we push, the value to stack. We compare these two, 0 and AX. If it is positive, jump to start. And if negative, it will print minus and negate AX here. It will print minus and it will negate AX. Now this start, we'll talk about this start which is over here. We to clear CX, we just XOR it and we move 10 into BX. Now push digits loop. We clear DX by XORing. We divide AX by BX and we push the digit that's the remainder in the stack. To count the digits, we've written increment CX and exit if 0 is remaining. like we've used or ax comma ax for that. Now again move ah comma 0 to h because we have to display a single character. Now this pop underscore and underscore display underscore loop. This loop is just to pop the digit in dx. It will convert the decimal into ASCII code. And again, this is the interrupt, the MS-DOS interrupt. This will be used to restore the CX and then we return. So this is the end of this procedure. This procedure that is disp underscore array underscore at underscore SI underscore decimal. And this will be the end of the program as well. I hope you all understood the program. So now we will display the output for the bubble sort. We have taken 5 elements in the array. So now we'll see the output. As you can see, all the 5 elements that we have taken have been sorted and they are in the decimal form. So this is we have finished the video for the bubble sorting and we hope you liked it.